immunotherapy is really using the body's immune system to treat cancer. And so the immune system is a part of the body that really specializes in defending the body from invaders. And sometimes those invaders come from outside, for example, bacteria and viruses, and sometimes they can be inside, such as a cancer cell. We do believe that there is a battle that goes on between the cancer cell trying to survive and the immune system trying to eradicate it. And in fact, we actually believe that probably cancer is much more common than we really think, and we don't know about it because the immune system is actually, in most patients, very effective at getting rid of it. And in fact, once in a great while in some cancers, we'll even see the cancers go away with the native immune response. So a lot of work has been done over the last few years to try to stimulate the body's natural immune system as a way to treat cancer. There have been a variety of approaches, and so the ones that seem to work very well lately have been a group of molecules that really target what we call checkpoints. And so T cells are very complicated cells. So these cells have more proteins than any other cell in the human body, and they're tightly regulated. And the reason for that is, let's say you have an acute viral illness. You really want to get that T cell response going. You want to clear the virus, and then you want to get rid of that T cell so you don't get an autoimmune reaction. So in many ways, a lot of these proteins serve as what we like to consider a rheostat for the T cell. You want to be able to turn it on when you need it, and you want to be able to turn it off when you don't need it. And so the new set of molecules, which have been referred as a group, we call them T cell checkpoint inhibitors, really have focused on preventing the turning off of the rheostat in the T cell. And when you keep that cell on for a longer period of time, we're seeing absolutely dramatic reductions across a variety of different cancers. There are now actually 3 FDA-approved drugs like this in melanoma. 2 of these drugs have now been approved for the treatment of lung cancer, and we're widely expecting many other clinical trials in other cancers to be completed shortly, and we think this can impact a very large number of patients. We also have been working here in New Jersey on a different approach, which uses what we call an oncolytic virus. And so these are viruses that can actually infect tumor cells. They will replicate and kill the tumor cell, and then they can generate an immune response, which is exactly what you would expect from a virus. However, when these viruses infect normal cells, they can't replicate, and so they have a very important safety feature. This could really be a major game changer in the field because these have been very well tolerated. One of the side effects that we see is that if you stimulate the immune system too much, you can get what's called autoimmunity. And that's where the immune system can start, in fact, attacking the normal tissues. And so some of the treatments that we do, we have seen that happen, not with all of them, but that seems to be easily controlled. So we typically use corticosteroids sometimes to control those kind of side effects. And interestingly, that has not really interfered with the therapeutic activity of some of these agents. These are not the kind of permanent kind of side effects that you can get with chemotherapy. They're not as debilitating to patients' quality of life. You know, we don't see the nausea, your hair doesn't fall out, and most patients can work and function relatively normally. They have to come into the clinic a bit more often, but what I like to tell the patients is, even if we're not curing the cancer, we're often turning it into a more chronic disease like diabetes. We don't ever really cure diabetes, but if you take your medication, you can live many, many years with the disease. I think where we're going in the future is to try this in other cancers outside melanoma, and we're also very interested in using this in combination approaches. So, for example, to combine the virus with the T-cell checkpoint inhibitors. And the first trial of that we've actually been conducting here, and we're already seeing very dramatic responses in a very large number of patients.